First films of Cuban rebel leader Fidel Castro and his ragged force in their mountain stronghold, made shortly before fighting erupted in all six of Cuba's provinces. This is the band, numbered at about 1,000, that for 16 months has held out in the rugged Sierra Maestra mountains near the island's eastern tip. Ill-supplied, they make many of their weapons in crude jungle workshops. Mines and grenades made here have proved as unreliable as they are makeshift. One of Castro's most potent weapons has been the mimeograph. Pronouncements and propaganda have circulated throughout Cuba by pamphlets and by radio, despite secret police efforts to stamp out the underground. Castro himself has become a figure of legend in the 16 months since he invaded Oriente province from a small boat. The rebels' actual achievements were few for most of that time, but by mere existence and survival, Castro's force has both grown and exerted an influence out of all proportion to its size. Castro's plan of action? To fight by any means until the Batista regime is toppled. Sabotage proved effective in paralyzing Oriente province for weeks before the general outbreak of fighting. But Oriente is the province most remote from the heart of the country. The ragged, underfed, poorly armed rebels cut off communications and supply lines in a campaign of sniping and sabotage. But every time they have clashed in the open with Batista's hard, efficient army and national police, rebels have lost heavily. Despite losses, they have fought on, and their numbers grow. Today, an estimated 1 man in 10 carries a modern rifle. The United States has embargoed arms for both sides. Occasional shipments are smuggled through from rebel sympathizers. It is an unequal battle of idealists against tough professional forces. Says Castro, if I lose, I'll start over again. If Batista loses, he loses for good. Cuba's strongman, who appeared with his family at a press reception, seemed untroubled by Castro's mounting offensive. Behind Batista stand the army, the police, and apparently Cuba's labor unions, who withheld support from Castro's general strike call. Batista seemed upset about reports in the American press of police brutality and corruption, but confident in the face of an unpredictable future.